In today's video, we're going to take a look at how to set up and edit your confirmation emails for the Tee Time Management Program. So there's a couple things to take into consideration when you're setting this up. The first spot we're going to go is in Tee Time Management, Files, and Confirmation Notice Designs. As soon as you go in here, if you haven't set this up before, you're going to set up a new design code. I'm going to go into one that I've already created. And then on the right-hand side, there's a couple different things that you can configure. We'll start off with the header and footer details. In here, you can adjust and edit the subject, salutation, the introduction for new tee time reservations, as well as any changed reservations or moved reservations, as well as any footer details. Now, the text that you see here, this will be on your side by default, but of course, you can edit anything in here that you'd like. Below that, we have the cancellation details. So if a member cancels, you can adjust the subject, salutation, introduction, and footer details. Now, as a side note, anything that's surrounded by those percentage marks, that field will come in automatically for who that member is or what club it is. Below that, we have the reservation details. So in here, there's a bunch of checkboxes. If you're curious about any specific checkbox, I would click the F1 button on your keyboard. That will bring up a help screen for each one of these fields. But it depends on what you want to include on that confirmation email. So I'm going to include the confirmation number, date, tee time, course name, and number of players in the group. And at my club, we do a lot of double starts or crossovers as well as shotguns. So I'm going to include the starting hole as well. Below that, we have the letterhead details. This is where you can add a logo for your club as part of that confirmation email. So all you need to do is turn on that flag and choose your logo. And then it's just a matter of configuring the coordinates and the adjustments left, right, or up and down for that logo. So there's a little bit of a trial and error design when you're setting that up, but you can always print that confirmation notice design and view it as you go along. Below there, we have an options section. In here, there's a couple different checkboxes as well. Just to name a few of them, you can include a calendar attachment to that confirmation email. And then you can also notify all bookings for a change to a tee time. Now, what that means is if I sign up as a twosome for the 8 a.m. time, if somebody else signs up as in that 8 a.m. time, I'm going to get an email letting them know that there was a change to my tee time, another twosome has been added. Okay, but once again, I would use the F1 notes if you have any other questions about any of those flags in there. And then lastly, there's a couple fields in here that you can edit yourself. You can print the club information on the confirmation notice. So just turn on that flag and you can input any text you want. Same thing with the print player name on confirmation notice design. So you can turn that on if you'd like. And then at the bottom, there's a notes section as well. So you can turn that on and input any sort of notes you'd like. Now, the next thing to consider for your confirmation emails is this option right here, the confirmation notice design links. In here, the only thing that this controls is you can control what format of confirmation email you send out for the different golfer classifications at your club. So where this might come into play is you may want a different confirmation email design for your guest classification. So for my guest, I might want to include the directions to the golf course, might want to include a dress code policy on there. Whereas for my members, they should know all that information already, so they would have a different confirmation design. The next thing to take a look at for your confirmation notice designs is in the golf courses section. So that's under Tee Time Management, Files, and Golf Courses. Once you go in here, choose your golf course. And then on the right-hand side, you should see a communications option. In there, you can choose to send an email and or a push notification to your members for new reservations, modified, moved, or canceled reservations. And then on top of that, you can say, for new reservations, I'm going to send out an email and push notification unless it's booked within a certain amount of minutes of the tee time. So if your member comes into the golf shop and asks to book a tee time in 1 hour, of course, I'm not going to send an email to them. They're teeing off pretty soon. They don't need that confirmation email. The only other field in here to take a look at is this HTML confirmation notice form. And this is if you were to design your own confirmation notice form using HTML programming. So for more information on this, I will contact the support department at Jonas and they can fill you in on any other information for that field. The last thing we need to do to set this up is under System Administration, System Setup, and JML Parameters. Now, any sort of emailing you do out of Jonas, you'll have to set up these JMail parameters. That includes the tea time confirmations. So all you do is go in here, choose your company. And then under form type, if we look at that dropdown, there should be an option if we scroll down a little bit for tea time confirmation notices. So click on that. And then the next field right below that is the mail client. Now this depends on how you want to send out those emails. You can set it as Outlook.com, which means you would use the Outlook that's installed and logged in on your computer. Or you can set it to one of these SMTP options, in which case you or likely your IT would have to input the SMTP server name, and from address, in which case you can choose pretty much any email address that you'd like. Okay, if you're doing that as well, you may need to input the authentication on the right-hand side, and that's the port, login name, and password. Okay, once you've done that, you should be able to send out your tea time confirmation emails.